have food, but I must game first. That chest is only going to last for so long.
They got by a lot faster than I thought they were going to. It was supposed to be like 7:45. Oh shit, no, I didn't want to do that. First digit is odd. Two digits is 5, so it can either be 5 or the second digit can be 5. That doesn't really help me. Oh, fuck. That really doesn't help me. I'm not gonna get this one, am I? Okay. Fuck it. 55. Here we go. Poopy. Okay. Oh well. C'est la vie. Such is the way of things. Okay. So, let me go ahead and release these guys and then retrustify them. Oh, I don't even have him listed as being released. Oops. Why does it... Wait. Macro... Return trust all. Why didn't it return all of them? That's strange. Okay, time to get Najee back. There we go. Alright, we're back up to speed then. Now let's see if we can kill more orcs. And this, now that they're all level 5 like I am, even though it says level 4, am I only level 4? I'm level 5, motherfucker. You guys are like... Well, I guess this is probably one of the bad things about having the, this little, light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine. Having this little third-party thing, because I'm leveling so fast at this point that it doesn't really know what the hell to do, basically. Oh yeah, Najee's gonna be tanking because Valenaril is a paladin first, so he's not gonna have provoke till level 10. So, Najee, you're gonna be useful for the first time, and the only time, up until level 10, because at that point you will no longer be useful. I would like you to know that. Not necessarily to be rude or, you know, in any way, like, distrustful. It's just I want to make sure you understand your place in the world, so to speak. You know, you have passing use. And since you're now stunned over there, you're showing me how good that passing use is. Thank you. Punch them, please. A little harder than that, I'd appreciate it. There we go, that's better. Now, do I have... That's level 11. That's level 8 that I have access to that. That is correct. Now, I need to find myself another scarab beetle. I just gotta find one more scarab beetle, then I can spend, like, the rest of my 15-minute exposure. That food smells so good, you don't even understand. That I can find the rest of that, like, seriously, my mouth is starting to water because that smells so unbelievably delicious. But I wanted to get my... The remaining... Like, 50, what is it? It was going to be like 15 minutes to get to level like 12 or 15 because of how quickly I level with all of this crap. It's, I mean, I'm at level 6 right now and it's been like what? 702. Okay, it's been, okay. I'm apparently full of shit. It's been way longer than that. Screw it. It's going to be quick, all right? It's going to be a quick thing, so. Host! Boom, shakalaka! Oh, you concealed treasure chest. You're too kind to me, but I don't have time for you. Okay, 31 tabs. Now, are there more scarab beetles? Okay, north, east, and just incredible. Okay, just in front of me. Got it. All right, so I can kill them, then kill the remaining orcs, and then I can spend the remainder of my days in Gelsba Outpost, getting ready for my, skirmish to get my rank 2, I think is how we're gonna be working this bad boy. Jaggedy or Jack isn't up, right? Like, I might be too far north, I'm probably not gonna be able to see it. Yeah, he's way too far north, okay. Or I'm way too far north, or he's way too far south. Whatever, words are hard. That food smells so good, and it makes my tummy go rumble. So many treasure chests. Oh. Let me use that strip of meat jerky again since I was a dumbass and got myself killed last time. On the plus side, I'm getting skill ups pretty quick though. I'm only at 8 and mine probably maxed out at like 15 compared to everything else is 10 or 12. Wait, hold the fucking phone. Monks can use great axes? That is so baller. I love it. We totally should do that. Oh, you're like a temporary chest. I want that. Give me. I actually don't need that. I get the feeling that perhaps I may regret that sometime in the future. But I need to find another scarab beetle, and then I can kill whatever orcs I need along the way. Scarab beetle! It's like way the hell over this way. Honestly, I'm probably wasting time experience-wise just actually trying to complete this thing, but I like the tabs. The tabs are actually quite useful. Because those are the things I can use at the Field of Valor and Grounds Tomes sort of thing. So they are useful to keep around in case I need to get like reparation or different buffs and all that kind of stuff. Especially since I'm not going to be a red mage this time around. I will not have access to like invisible and sneak, which will suck balls. He has fucking red lotus blade already? Go fuck yourself. Thank you. So that's two, and now all I need to do is kill the remaining orcs, and then I will be good to go. And then I can create a vast swath of death and destruction and get my rank two. And then we can move on to probably the Thane Plateau to do all of the various rank two missions so I can get to rank three. And that way we can continue on with the Rhapsodies of Vanadile. Come here. Come here. I need to beat you. Okay, fine. I'll just walk in front of you and smack you that way. There you go. You're easy prey. Please. How very unfortunate. I need something that's tougher, better. Come here. I got like four people on me. With me. Whatever. To have very different connotations. I really need to be careful about, you know, how I conjugate certain things, I'm sure. You're easy prey? Aw, man. Well, I mean, I shouldn't be like, aw, man, because that's free fire crystals as far as I'm concerned. And that is, like, the best possible way to make money early on, is just steamrolling these guys. And, I mean, I'm getting freaking 207. I'm getting, like, almost 300 experience for an easy prey, which is just, like, mind-boggling. Back in the day, dude, and I know back in my day, you know, 200 experience was the cap you could get for, you know, incredibly tough monsters. And easy prey, even with the experience band was, like, 50 experience most, because easy prey back in my day was 32 experience. Because I very distinctly remember it. Even match was 100 experience. A decent challenge was either 72 experience or 50 experience, depending upon how close in level he was to you. And the closest easy prey was 32 experience. Then it went to like 26, then 20, and then 16, I think is the lowest that it went. And then after that point, it was like, sorry for you, you ain't getting experience, go F yourself. It's good times, man. It smells so good. There was cheesecake, and I got like, and I got mozzarella sticks, and then I got a Philly cheesesteak sub. Nom. Carnivore Aaron needs meat. Murder him, please. He's a goddamn easy prey, dude. There we go. Level 8, bitches. Let's get that gear going. Kenpoji, Teko, Sitabaki, and Kaihan. There we go. Looking sexy. Shaking that ass. Oh, I hear you. Alright, that's cool. You want to play that game? I can play that too. Watch this shit. Shabam! Dead before you can get two shots off. Maybe three. There we go. Just like I said, dead before you can get two shots off. Ha ha. Okay. And I think for the, for that save the children thing, I think I can bring trusts in, which one will make it kind of, like, pointless. And I mean, you can... It's not scaled down anymore, so, I mean, you can be freaking level 99 and do that shit if you wanted to. Which kind of makes it a joke. I think... The funny thing is, I think on this server, which is Sora, I think somehow for the Save the Children mission, my other character, Grundy, actually has the record for beating it fastest at, like... I want to say it was, like, 29 seconds or something like that, because I came in... I didn't even, like... get my trusts. I didn't even bring any of those them in. I just came in with my a level 50 warrior with my great axe, walked in, and two-shot everything. I one-shot the small mobs and two-shot the main boss mob. And I was like, woohoo, I'm done. Yay! Surprise! Okay. I mean, if there is a complaint I can make about trust, and it's like the most bullshit complaint ever, I'm just like, ugh. I have to resummon them in every zone, so it takes like a whole freaking 20 seconds to get, you know, four equivalent to real people that are probably in a lot of cases better than real people because they actually do their function goddamn jobs. Oh, life is so tough. Kappa. Okay, fodder. Where you at? But you better believe all. Oh, best fight music. Protectra. I love the Protectra. I love buffs. It's also funny how the orcs get comparatively bigger or smaller depending upon what level they are, I think. Or maybe that's just, you know, perspective and, you know, distance and shit. That's probably perspective and distance and shit. Come here, stone launcher. There you go. That's right. Fight me! I will say, this is a one of the more original models you'll see. You just see this giant, weird, wooden, dragon-like structure shooting arrows at you. I made the mistake of trying to solo one of these once, and I was like, oh, he's like a decent challenge. He's not that bad. No, he fucked me up. He fucked me up real bad, dude. Like, I can't even fully explain just how badly, because everything was going okay, and then he did something, like, weapon skill, like a weapon skill or a special ability, and it quite literally, it was like a weird water jet spray thing that took about 85% of my health off, and you would be very surprised how quickly your tone goes from, oh, this is no problem, I can take this shit, no problem, to, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my fucking god, I'm gonna die, because it was scary. It was decidedly unpleasant. It scared the living shit out of me. And I'm really, really trying to extend the time here until the bind runs out so I can actually, there we go, thank you. On the plus side, all of my NPCs are now in perfect shape, which is a plus. Where's the grunt? Where's the grunt? Where are the grunts? I'm gonna be a dumbass. Come here. There you go. Now, hopefully this won't end as badly as it did with me trying to do this at level 1, and it won't end as badly as me trying to do this with a warrior. Which ended poorly, let's just put it that way. Score. Alright, I just need the boost, and then we're gonna kick this guy's ass. Good boy Najee actually using provoke on cooldown. There are not a lot of tanks who would normally do that. Could you please hit him? I'm at goddamn 986 TP. Come on, man. Get fucked. 25 damage, get wrecked. Yeah. Know what that means? Release and then re-trustimify. So that way they have the same level I do and all the existing stats. Yay! So how many? 4 out of 10, huh? Okay. So I need to kill 6 more Gelsba mobs and then I'll be good to go. And then I can actually go into your gut grotto there. Because they're all like Volcrum Dunes-esque level and I can probably futz my way around with those. Basically, they're the same level as the Orcish Grunt here. Come here, baby. There you go. That's right, protectify us. While I stand back here and just casually kind of do my thing. I fucking love this music, man. I mean, you get tired of it after you hear it for, you know, the 3,000th time after about 2 years, but, you know, for battle music, it's really pretty damn, like, pumped up. Though I do notice that they changed it. Again, back in my day, if you weren't actually, like, in like, this sort of active mode, this combat mode, the music would stop playing. Even if you were aggroing, even if you were in a group, the music would not play. So, if you played a caster, like a white mage or whatever, groups were the most boring fucking thing alive because music did not play. And all you heard was this. Well, luckily you would hopefully hear that sound, but you would hear this. For hours at a time. Shit, I just love... I'm not fucking bringing them back out again. I'm gonna fight 5 more mobs. And then I'm gonna go and get my conflict in your gut grotto. And then I'm gonna hopefully at that point be... Yeah, my thing is still saying level 8 up there. That's kind of funny. And then I'm going to go and, hopefully by that point I will actually have enough levely goodness to, take down 1.3 and get this shit taken care of. Come here. Come here. Come here. Where you going? Where you going? Where you going? Fight me! At PAX! Alrighty. Alright. You guys do have levels, right? Like, yeah, okay, good. I don't know what the hell that sentence structure was, but it was an attempt at a sentence structure. Sentence. It was an attempt at a structured sentence. There we go. See, I have food next to me, so now my brain is not doing the things that it should be doing, which is pretty scary because I don't do the things I should be doing ordinarily. So now that you're distracting me further, my brain is just like and mozzarella sticks. Get fucked. Thank you. 214 experience. This is just obscene and I fucking love it. What can I say? I'm a sucker. Ooh, I got a sardonyx earring. Okay, I'm starting to definitely see the importance of doing this. That is, this being, you know, doing these records of eminence, like kill 10 things in this area for yada yada yada, because it's actually giving you, I didn't realize it actually gave you, at least as a first time bonus, I didn't realize it gave you actual items that you can equip and stuff like that. I thought it was just quite literally, you know, like, hey, you know, it's there. Like, cool, it gives you stuff. Like, I thought it just gave you experience and shit. I didn't realize that it was an added bonus effect, basically, is what I'm trying to say. However, since I'm going to be going to your gut grotto, it might be taking a little longer to kill everything here. But provided I don't die horribly and basically make an ass out of myself, that will bring me to probably like level 13, 14, at which point I can wreck, you know, what's-his-face's face. Wreck what's-his-face's face. Sounds legit. I'm trying so hard not to cough right now, you don't understand, because I swallowed too much apple juice and it kind of hurts now. Oh, apple, I mean, it's the juice of a fruit. It's kind of, it is, you know, acidic by nature, but I mean, it's fucking apple juice. It's not supposed to be that acidic. Good times, man. Good times. It's a wonderful day for an exorcism. Okay. So, you got grotto. It's pretty fucking scary. It's pretty scary shit. Hi! Come here. Come here. Oh, I got both of them fighting me right now. Oh, shit. That is not the intent. Oh my god, he's level fucking 18. Okay, so we're gonna switch targets to the grotto bats and kill them first. We're gonna kill them first because we actually can kill them first. He's yeah, I just realized that he is significantly much stronger than I am, which is kind of unfortunate. Okay, maybe I won't be going to your gut grotto. Maybe. Maybe I won't be going to... Yeah, because he's, like, way higher level than what I was expecting him to be. Way higher level than what I was expecting him to be, and I would rather not die again. But that's a good boy, Valeneral. You go ahead and you tank the shit out of that mob while nobody can hit him. And if nothing else, it's good skill-ups, I suppose. But she's gonna be running out of mana pretty goddamn soon. So, we need to, like, get in on this shit pretty quick. Am I level 10 or level 11? Fuck, I'm still only level 10. Okay. I think we can do it. I think we might be able to manage it. Maybe. Because we're all... This, again, this is a Final Fantasy XI party. Just very slowly plunking away at something that's so goddamn strong you have no right fighting it. And basically wasting all of your mana and all of your skills to basically get it down and then resting for 5 minutes while waiting for it to come back. Because at this point, my healer is out of mana. So this is going to be very unfortunate. Because I really hope one of these motherfuckers can cast a heal. Because if not, this is going to get really nasty really quick. Yeah, they can totally do it. Sweet. All right. They just don't do it until he's in, like, orange health, I suppose. I guess that's the way they're programmed. Okay, I mean, that's fair. Just don't fucking die, that's all. And all you gotta do is just not die. That's the point of everything in life, is just don't die. Hey, Najee, that's not bad. He popped his provoke because the other guy was half dead. Okay. That's not bad. That's some interesting, stuff right there. Alright. So, how long do I have before I can take these guys? Okay. Alright. Okay. Okay. That was 780 experience, though, so that was... I think that was well worth the wait. These are incredibly tough. Are you incredibly tough, too? You are incredibly tough. Hold up. For one, I gotta make sure you guys have, like, the correct amount of stuffs. Because if I try to attack him with nothing at all, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna die. Like, horribly. Come on. Res your shit, please. Come on. I know you can do it. At this point, I could have left and then zoned back in, and I probably would have spent less time waiting and doing absolutely nothing. But I want to do it... I don't say do it the legit way. I mean, Jesus Christ. Come on, guys. Any fucking time now. This area is scary. Come here. Alright, back we go. So long as I'm not attacking, I think that they'll continue to regen their self. So at least this way I'm making something. Come on. I know you can make it. You gonna run back? Yep, there you are. Okay. Okay. So he's a ranger. Oh, that's very wise, guys. That's real wise. Okay. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna combo, because I can. And I guess they're going for a Valeneral, because I guess he just has innately higher attack. This is kind of why Najee sucks. Poor Najee. Oh well, they're keeping themselves alive, so yeah, he's definitely gonna be doing the better tanking stuff, because right now Najee can't heal and Valeneral can. So Valeneral is giving himself hate. But yes, welcome to Final Fantasy parties. You're just beating the shit out of them very, very slowly, and then just nothing. For potentially several minutes at a time as you're resting up. But it's kind of exhilarating in its own weird way to actually, like, be teaming up on a mob that by itself could just wreck the shit out of people unless you have a organized group together, you know what I mean? It gives the over... And to realize that the entire world... In this game of Warcraft, that the entire world in this game, all of the mobs in this game have this same level of, you know, blow fuckery. It's not just, you know, it's more than... Are you gonna fight me? There you are. Okay. He didn't make an aggro sound. That was my bad. But, you know, that the entire world is actually mobs like this. It's not just dungeons. It's not just, you know, the occasional, like, instance area or the occasional group area. It's actually every goddamn mob in the game is this strong comparative to yourself. So they'll basically destroy you. So the world is a very, very dangerous place. And it does not... It is not for the timid. And even with it being easier, it still provides a nice feeling of accomplishment when you fight something like this and you're just like, yeah, fuck you, I'm doing 4 damage. Go F yourself. I am the king of the goddamn world, thank you very much. I will have you know. Red Lotus Blade, still one of the coolest effects ever. So salty that it actually doesn't really do shit for damage. But them's the berries, I suppose. Do I have a thingy for... spoils. Spoils. Do I have one for fire crystals? I do. Awesome. Fantastic. I was gonna be kind of salty with myself. You need to heal his ass quick. Heal him. He must receive the heals. Alright. So what am I at? Hey guys, I forgot to turn the conflict on. Yeah. Yeah. So, just like accepting a quest, you need to actually, like, accept the quest. Like, the whole fucking thing, the whole kit and caboodle. It's not just going to magically happen because you're there. It's, yeah. Yeah. I'm on the plus side, that was like 2 levels from just fighting like 3 mobs, so that's fucking fantastic to me. Macros. Edit macro. Copy. Paste. Yes. Change the name to MNK. Mink. Confirm. Okay. So we're gonna do this. We're gonna make a couple of quick changes here. Oh god, what have I fucking done? Okay. So we're gonna make it. What I said. Like, what do you... Oh, it's up front. Okay. So we're gonna do job ability. Boost me. Weight 1. And combo T. So that way it will boost and then immediately combo, and that way I don't have to do that bullshit navigating of menus thing. And I won't accidentally waste the boost on something that is actually unworthy of such boostiness. Like, you know, an auto attack, which is the other 90% of my fucking job. Come here, baby. How adorable. You wanna kill me? Oh, is that so cute? Oh yeah, we got Cure 2 going on, baby. Now all I need to do is start this all over again and kill 10 of these motherfuckers and we'll be good to go. Don't attack me, don't attack me, don't attack me, don't attack me. But, Millie, you seriously need to, like, not waste your mana. Seriously need to not waste your mana. Oh yeah, he's ranged. So, let's run very far away. So that way, if and when these things respawn, they don't spawn on top of me and murder me. Because as evidenced, ads in this game are bad. They're real bad. They will do very bad things to your body in a very short amount of time. There we go. Double Voke. That's cool. So does Najee actually have more health than he does? He might. He might actually have a little bit more health, but then warriors do have a bit more health than paladins, but paladins have MP and a much higher defense rating and etc. Purple Monkey Dishwasher. Oh, but this feels good, guys. It feels good to actually fight things that are tough and actually you know, use my NPCs to do this kind of stuff. As stupid as the combat is, I actually very much enjoy it. Which is hilarious, because in a lot of times I hate it. Level 12, hell yeah! So, what we're gonna do... we're gonna run back out... and we're gonna run back in so I can reset the trust... so I can reset the timer for the trust NPC. So that way I don't... because the reason that I'm unspawning, despawning, and respawning them is that they do not level with me. So when I level, and I'm level 12, they're still listed as level 11, which means that they don't get... wait a minute. Fuck, which way is which? This is the way that's in. Okay. Cameraman. So I have to unsummon them and resummon them for them to take effect of what my level currently is. Now, that apparently is not the case once you hit max level. They go by whatever your item level is, and that will automatically update, but that's not the case for levels. Why, I don't know. But another trick to speed up the leveling process when you have these trusts is that if they run low on MP or they're low on health, they have like a 4 or 5 minute respawn, like a recast timer, but... you know, if that timer is up and they're low on health or magic or whatever, you can actually just go ahead and despawn and respawn them so that way they can get like a quick full heal. So, it's pretty sweet. All in all, big fan of the trust system. If they'd had something like this back in 2005, I'd have probably never quit because I would have had the ability to do something outside of a group. I wouldn't have had to wait for hours upon hours at a time to be able to do stuff. And maybe that's just because I sucked and people avoided me. Maybe that's why I waited hours upon hours. I don't know. I'm just saying, it wore on me after a while. And I wouldn't be surprised if people avoided me because I sucked, because I actually kind of, looking back upon it now, I was a total fucking scrub. I had no idea what I was doing. I was just making shit up as I was going and hoping it worked. I mean, like, if I saw a 19-year-old me, I'd smack the shit out of her. Such is the way of things. That's how life goes, you know? That's the way life goes, that's the way life goes. Whoa-oh-oh-oh. Or whatever the hell that song goes. Early 90s song, you won't get the joke. I'm sorry. I tried. But seriously, imagine getting 200 experience per kill like this, except that it took longer, there was more downtime, and it was, you actually had to travel to from one place to another. Go fuck yourself, Grotto Bat. You know not of what you do. Just saying. Boost and then combo that ass. Did I just miss? No. Okay, good. Rotobat, you are pissing me off, dude. Synchronized healing, I do love it though. Rotobat, you need to go F yourself. Go F yourself, Rotobat. There you go. Alright. I get off the screen, fucker. There we go. Is he fighting Najee? Nope. Still fighting what's-his-face. The conflict still- okay, good. The conflict is still working by me leaving and coming back in, so that is a plus. You got Grotto, can go fuck itself. Good. I got friends. Oh, Jesus, they're respawning. Oh, this is not a good place to be. Okay. So, Najee provoked, I think, because Villaniel and both XML were tank. I don't know why I'm providing the play-by-play for this specifically. I just kind of am, I guess. Ha! Yeah, you guys! I'm going home. Okay. Elise. Please tell me your timer isn't up. Please tell me your timer isn't up. Please tell me your timer isn't up. Oh, that was a mistake. Oh, it's like 15 seconds. That's not that bad. I can survive 15 seconds, I think. I'm just gonna duck behind this cave here. And they will be none the what. Don't, You stay over there. Suddenly, when you don't have 4 or 5 summonable NPC friends that can help you at any given time, world becomes a hell of a lot scarier. Suddenly, it is a very big, terrifying, scary place that can basically eat you alive in a matter of seconds. Just the way God intended. Alright, now to put on my little, like, my little floaty swimmy, guys. You know what? Pardon the sound. Is this my cheesecake? That is my cheesecake! We got cheesecake, bitches! We have cheesecake! We are go for cheesecake. Oh shit, I don't have a fork. Alright. I expected that to take longer than it did. Okay. Let's go. Neck chopper. Oh, you're a fucking mage. Oh, that is unfortunate. You're really going hard on that protector and that shelver, aren't you? I understand why. Having said that, my food's wore off. All right. Don't fuck with me, neck chopper. Don't fuck with me, neck chopper. I see you back there. Don't even start shit with me. But it's amazing how once you get a couple of levels, these guys really aren't as threatening. And I'm saying this knowing full well that I'm full of shit, because again, if I were to lose even one of these people, all of a sudden my life is a vortex of pain and misery and that I have invited upon myself, and I am the only one to blame. I am aware of this. Okay, I need to kill 2 more mobs, then I can get the hell out of here. I can complete my 1-3 quest and I am good to go. Boost and boom! Oh, I'm really hoping that I could get a skill chain going so you guys can see what it looks like, because I love skill chains. Oh, the 90s was really awesome in that really kind of like weird, like entering puberty kind of way where, you know, the burgeoning of technology and the, you know, the very birth of the internet, but it still wasn't so pervasive that it had, you know, completely changed the way you view the entire world and reality as a whole. You know, it was still just a far-off dream. You know, cell phones were the size of your fucking head. You know what I mean? So what am I gonna get? What are we gonna get? I got an onyx earring. Yay! Oh god, I'm gonna sneeze. Ow. Ow. I sneeze like a dying giraffe. It kind of hurts. MP plus 2. Okay. That's right. Damn, those things were expensive back in the day, weren't they? You needed those things for casting-related stuffs, and it sucked. Ow, thank you. Ah. Now I need to blow my nose, and now I have to... The tantalizing view of a cheesecake, right? Piece of a cheese... Ah, blah, blah, slice of cheesecake in front of me. God damn it, words. Why do you betray me so? So I'm gonna recastify these dudes. And then we're gonna go do the thingamadoodle. I'm gonna fight my way up and save the children and then probably suicide so that way I can get back to town because I didn't give myself a warp scroll. Because I'm lazy. Have I really been playing for 3 hours? I totally have. Alrighty then. Oh. Double the pleasure, double the fun, double the grunts with double mint gum. Okay. Let's go. Let's do this shit. Funnily enough, the other grunt is completely unaware of everything going on. And bear in mind, I would like to remind you, this is not a private server. This is... the real fucking McCoy. In-game AI, man. It was fucking beautiful. And I'm sure there have been many a Penny Arcade comic strip devoted to that very simple process of one person getting murdered while the other person is just like, hey, Bob, you want a pizza? What are you at, anyway? You're an even match? Okay, that ain't bad. You're suddenly way less frightening once I can actually kick your ass. And you don't one-shot me. That's how I learned that particular fucking welcome wagon. Alright. So let's go. Let's go save us some children, shall we? So I may have been a little bit off in the amount of time it would take me to get from like 1 to 13-ish or so. I fully understand. But it wasn't that off. I mean, it was like 30, 45 minutes to get from 1 to 15, whereas this was a several hour long process back in the day. And that means I can actually get this taken care of, get that, words. Where did they go? I completely lost my train of thought. Fuck it. But I can complete the quest. I complete the mission, can get rank 2, and that way I can basically move on with my life. Orcish fodder! You gonna fight me? You gonna fight me? Nope. Nope, I think I'm beyond the aggro point for most of these mobs now since I'm level 13. And I think back in the day, the level cap for this was, I think, level 13. You couldn't go any higher than level 13, and obviously there weren't trusts, so... Sup? How you doing? Glad to hear it. Okay, let's see. Save the children. I said save the children. Aw, it's 27 seconds. The res held by 2 adventurers, including Colt. Aw. I guess I lost, and you know, mine was 29 seconds, I think. Oh, well. What? Oh, this is unfortunate. Hang on a second. Hang on a second. I didn't realize that, You can wait there, right? Like, it's okay. It's all good. Just give me about 45 seconds to, rest up here, and then I will be happily, able to talk to you about any and all diplomatic issues you need, Fado Cheese Vadgut. Fuck your name. I don't understand it. But while they're doing this, I'm grabbing myself a fork. Cheesecake. I'm a professional. I do this for a living. I swear, I actually literally don't, and if I did, no disrespect to Twitch, but it'll probably be very pathetic for me, because I'm bad at it. Like, I'm real bad at it. Okay, here we go. All right, take 2. Now, what was that you said about my mama? I got 3 elves and a baby, man. I was gonna say 3 elves and a Naji, but she's a Mithra, whatever. Oh, I got 3 cures and a Naji. There we go. Alrighty, let's go. I mean, I ain't gonna be winning any. Excuse me? Can I? Thank you. Let's get that protector going, shall we? That way I can see them. And he's dead. And dead. And dead. Get fucked. Thank you. Short shot snatgat. That sounds like a euphemism of some kind. You think you won? Your time soon end. Your days is numbered. Me say so. Ugh, ugh. Ugh, ugh. Dee-dee-doo. Awesome. Now, I'm going to do it correctly this time and actually go back into the orc hut. Because the last time I remember doing this, I got all the way back to fucking town and I was like, why isn't the quest done? Because the orc hut key, I actually had to go back and talk to the orc hut, apparently. Wait! Sandy music is the best, dude. You are the adventurer that Peyush sent, are you not? Bravely have you fought against the orcs. Well done! On behalf of my spineless brother, I thank you. Had he not the strength to save one boy, so he sent adventure in his stead. Indeed, he is dirt upon the name of House Dorgyle. Well, enough blather. Let us save the boy. Open the door! What, you gonna fucking, like, steal my kill? Really? Is anyone here? Why, your highness! Are you Tedamount from the cathedral? Yes, it's me! Truly, I am grateful you came, your highness! I am relieved he seems well. I will bring joy. Ah, I will bring the boy back to Sandoria. You have my thanks, adventurer. I will inform the guards of your deeds. Now, let us be off. I know, right, Tryon? Before the actual Tryon existed, right? Excuse me? Oh, they ain't attacking me. Okay. That's cool. So, that's gnarly. I don't have an instant warp scroll, do I? I do not. So, what we're gonna do is I need to, like, suicide myself so I can run back quickly. Is there a way I can... Please, fuck it. 2 weak to be worthwhile. Alright, I need something strong that can kill me. Oh, I know. Can I run back in there, start the Save the Children thing again, and then just get myself killed? Or will that fuck the quest up? Okay. Nope. Totally cannot do that. That is unfortunate. Alright, I need to find something that can kill me relatively quickly. Better check your funds to make sure they didn't take any. Yeah, it's unfortunate. I actually rather, I was really rooting for Tryon to not be total dickbags. I mean, maybe it's partially because I actually got into their fens and family alpha. Having said that, yeah. The sound quality in this game was actually quite good, and I was very happy. Okay. Okay. Ow. Okay, I just one-shot that. I was trying not to one-shot that. Okay. Come here. Come on. Come on, guys. Come here. Choo-choo! Chugga-chugga-chugga-chugga, choo-choo! Chugga-chugga-chugga-chugga, choo-choo! There we go. Now, I'm gonna eat my cheesecake while they murder me. This might take a while. Alright, I got the time. There's plenty of cheesecake for me to eat here. One whole delicious slice. By the way, for any of those not necessarily aware to the ways of Final Fantasy XI, this is called death warping or blood porting. And this is what happens when you don't either have the warp spell or an instant warp spell with which to take you back to your home point. You can just suicide yourself so they will just automatically spawn you back at your home point. Normally it would incur a loss of experience, but since I am below level 30, at least at this point in the game, it is not going to incur a loss, so it's basically me just standing here for 5 minutes and letting them murder me. But my rumble pad is rumbling like a motherfucker right now, though, I'll tell you that much. So how you guys doing today? Having a good day? Come here. Let me pull the rest of you. This isn't enough. I need more. You guys need to, like, pick up the pace here. I'm running out of cheesecake. There we go. I'm running out of cheesecake, so... I'll need to hurry it up, will ya? I'm sure there's a joke about Rule 34 in here somewhere, but I really don't feel like making it. It would be rather cheesy. Damn good cheesecake. Very good cheesecake. I would highly recommend it. I wish I could tell you the place I just ordered this from, but I have already forgotten. There we go. Hmm. Shit, I still have cheesecake left. I didn't think it was gonna take- okay. That's what you get for talking shit. It's the lightest and fluffiest cheesecake. Mm, delicious. Alrighty. Alright. Now, back to Andracian. Onward, comrade!
Prince Tryon just informed me of your handiwork. You've done beautifully. Due to your exemplary contribution, Naranai Sandoya hereby recognizes you as an adventurer of rank 2. Why 2? We like the number. But do not let it go to your head. The certificate is valid only in Sandoria. Work hard and better things will come, my friend. Someday your name will be known to our allies as well. Oh, and one more thing. The Rakesk of the Cathedral said he wants to thank you on behalf of the boy. Yeah, baby! Rank 2, bitches, and what? Be jealous. Aha! Okay, but seriously, like, I want to eat my food. So, I'm probably going to be hopping off for a while because my throat's also starting to hurt. I haven't done this whole, like, talking this long thing for quite some time. So, I will see you guys next time. I appreciate you stopping by. And I may stream a little bit later, and hopefully if my internet decides to hold up, I'll probably, maybe, hopefully stream tomorrow as well. But I will see you guys next time. Peace out.